Although we did get to talk to him. I'm not going to complain. Did you see where they were, like, number 7?
Yeah.
On the national level of the Lip-Sync PD competition.
Well, and apparently they hired 12 new officers, though. I kind of feel like they need a new video.
Need to start over.
We need to be inclusive. Get that.
Yeah. We don't want to exclude anyone.
Make the new people feel welcome.
Yep, absolutely.
Don't leave anybody out.
Don't leave anybody out.
Speaking of not leaving anybody out, did you see on Facebook where the lady was getting married and...
Oh, my goodness.
She canceled her wedding because, you know, y'all wouldn't send in the $1,500 to help pay for
all
it.
All she asked her guests for were $1,500 apiece. Okay? But, I mean, they were just going to have, like, a small shindig, but then they went to a psychic who said, no, you need to blow it out.
Go all out. Caribbean
wedding. Go big or go home.
And so she asked her guest list to give them...
To pitch in.
To pitch in $100 each. Not that much, according
minimum,
to her.
Minimum.
And how many guests did she invite? Do you know how much this wedding was going to cost total?
$60,000.
Woo!
Yeah, but it was going to be the dream wedding that the psychic told them they should have. Now keep in mind... They're no longer getting married.
So
they're going to ruin it. Just a skosh.
You ruined it, that's why.
So she decided she wasn't going to get married because her guests wouldn't do the $1,500 a piece.
Well, she got mad. Then she had falling out with some of the guests because they said, you're being unreasonable.
Uh-huh.
You know, and nobody likes to hear that.
No, Rodzilla.
I don't think that's too much to ask.
<Well, you laughs>
I read part of this, and then I didn't get to finish it because I had to leave and go somewhere, and I was going
to take $1,500 to a friend.
Sure. Just kidding, man. You're
on your way.
Is this the socialist way?
She's the one that's like, so I'm going to go backpacking through... I don't know, where is it, Africa?
For 2 years, you won't hear from me.
Yeah, to get in touch with herself.
What? That can't be cheap. Why didn't she use that money?
I'm sure she's using the money that she did get to go on the trip.
I would take her to court to get my $15. Jessica, could you represent me in that? Like, I didn't know. That money was for a wedding.
I think she got a little, pissy. GoFundMe page didn't get more than like $250, so.
I think they said she actually had one guest give her the money. And I think one other guest committed, but then backtracked. And so that's what caused the falling out.
Your mom doesn't count.
Yeah. So.
Hey, speaking of a GoFundMe, what do you guys think about the idea of, well, you know about Hillary, and now they're saying that China did,
missing 30,000 emails.
Yeah. So what if we had, like, we need to find out what China will take for these emails and start a GoFundMe for that. Like, we could raise funds.
To get the emails back.
To get the emails back.
And then what? Get Jeff Sessions to do something?
I don't know.
That's where it goes down.
No, we just want to read them.
Oh, right.
You know, I'm wanting to find out what yoga pose you got to do to, you know, to a scrub.
Oh, because that's the only thing that's in her emails is her
yoga
classes.
She looks like she does yoga.
Yeah, I'm thinking Hillary was not into the downward dog.
No, she was.
Or Bill would stay home.
That's right. Bill would stay home.
You or Bill, would you stay home?
Really, though. I mean, look at, does she look like she's real flexible? She does a lot of yoga. I just, I don't see it.
That's what she talks about on her private email.
Yeah, she's packed on a good 70 pounds. I don't think she's working out that hard.
She doesn't have emails anymore to do the yoga pose.
She doesn't know what to do.
We need those back.
Speaking of politics, though, I did see something that I thought broke everything down pretty well. So I just want to throw this out there. Because I know there's a lot of confusion about what socialism is, what fascism, you know, capitalism, all those things.
I'm not confused, they're all wrong.
I'm going to break it down. Socialism, you have two cows, give one cow to your neighbor. Okay?
Okay.
Communism, you have two cows, give both cows to the government, and they might give you some milk.
Okay.
All right. Fascism. You have two cows. You give all of the milk to the government, and the government sells it.
Okay.
All right. Nazism. You have two cows. The government shoots you and takes both.
Okay.
Anarchism. You have two cows. Keep both of the cows. Shoot the government agent and steal another cow.
Okay. Right.
Capitalism. You have two cows. Sell one cow and buy a bull. Just saying.
Make more.
There you go.
Surrealism. You have two giraffes. The government makes you take harmonica lessons. So, now that we all know what everything is.
Now we're confused. There's two more.
Which one of those scenarios sounds like the winner? Yeah. Just saying.
Too many isms. I'm going to start a no-ism.
No-ism.
No-ism. Yeah. How about the reality one?
The reality one?
Yeah. Your capitalism. That's reality.
Oh, yeah.
I think you should break that down for, what's her name? Alexandria Cortez? Yeah, you should break it down for her. She needs to, you might need to put that in simple terms.
She probably doesn't eat meat, so like... You have two...
And just because she's a political science teacher.
Two tofu plants, okay?
isn't that what she studied in school? Political science?
I don't even know.
Foreign relations.
I know that she's no longer willing to ride share in Ubers. So she's committed to taxis.
Oh, my.
Really?
Is that part of socialism? I don't think so. I think ride sharing would be...
Well, yeah, $4,000 a week, I think, is what she's racking up in her cab fare.
Wow.
Yeah. She's big enough to make demands, apparently, so.
She needs to be sharing that $4,000 with somebody.
Did you know absolutely no candidate that she has endorsed has won? None. Zero.
Well, I can see why. I said before, it's like, remember Jennifer, what was her name? She was married to Ben Affleck,
Jennifer Garner.
Remember her character on 13 Going on 30? It's like they've elected her. Like she's
she's the one.
She's it. She's in. Yeah.
Somebody's really cleaning out here this morning.
Is it Ben Shapiro's running against her?
Well, I hope she's not gonna. He's not gonna want to debate her because
yeah,
that's sexist.
That is sexist. Nobody wants that.
Hey, we were talking about her probably not eating animals. Did you guys hear about the, I'm all over the place, but...
They were veganism.
Did you hear about the animal crackers? Like, they're coming out, but they're bringing the animals out of their cages.
Oh, so last week.
Yeah, we covered that last week.
Oh, well, it's gone.
Yeah.
Oopsies.
Yeah.
You know, this came down on you.
I'm just going to throw this out there. If you don't show, you still have to listen.
Well, I didn't start listening until it was a little ways in before I started listening. But the main thing was, I got here. I made it.
You protected our honor. Kept us safe.
So, yeah.
In other news, the 2018 Darwin nominees are out.
Oh, let's hear about this.
So, this particular gentleman, he's in Malaysia. He spotted a 12-foot python sleeping on the side of the road and thought, hey, that's worth some money. So, he picked it up successfully, got it, held it, transported it on his motorcycle as he was holding it. And swinging in the air, the snake got a little upset and wrapped its body around the captor, who then wrecked and died of asphyxiation.
Oh, okay.
Strangulation.
It almost sounds like the lady that was walking her dog and was
trying to save her from the alligator.
And the alligator eats her.
I know, she did not make the list.
I said, like, bye, Fluffy.
Nice to meet you, buddy.
I kept dog at home. I'm sorry.
That's one award you don't want to get is a Darwin.
No, right.
You don't want to get
<'Cause> it. <you're dead. laughs> <You're posthumous. laughs> This particular Darwin nominee, these two guys got in a collision, a car wreck, and they got out of their cars and started arguing. Then they got physical, And then, while they were being physical, they managed to throw themselves into the oncoming traffic lane and get slammed into by a truck, and both died.
Wow, so nobody won.
Nobody won that car wreck.
It'd be a good idea to pull over for that.
Then we got the England man who suffered a fatal heart attack after getting his head stuck beneath an electric footrest at the movies while trying to get his cell phone off the floor.
Oh my god.
That could happen to me.
That was wrong.
That's an accident. That's too familiar.
That's a horrific accident.
The 71-year-old woman in Germany who died while smoking outside the hospital got third-degree burns after her oxygen ventilator ignited, setting fire to the plastic upholstery on her wheelchair.
I've seen that before. I've been outside the hospital and people drag their tanks out
and smoke.
Oh,
yeah. There used to be smoking sections in the restaurants, and there was an older man that used to come in when I was young and I waited tables, and he had an oxygen tank and he would smoke.
Yeah,
it was a little scary. Nobody really wanted to be the one waiting on him.
You do realize why you're on oxygen, right?
Yeah.
Crazy.
Yeah, that's too real.
Too real. All right. I don't like the cell phone. All right. Lastly, we got the 50-year-old man in Romania. He was hospitalized and died after taking home a projectile he found in the field outside his village. He decided to pound it with a hammer, causing an explosion.
Oh.
I don't have to go with the snake.
Yeah.
The snake to me is
snake wins.
I think the snake wins, for sure.
Yeah.
Because the snake's still alive.
The snake is still alive. Oh, and there was another one that was so good. I missed it, but it was a lovely little couple, married couple. And, let's see. They were walking down the street. I don't know how I missed this one, because I kind of like this one. And they got into a little bit of a quarrel. He was trying to make his point. She was trying to make hers. And he got frustrated because he was not winning. Obviously, he was the man winning.
Of course.
And so he shoved his wife into the icy river. And then he jumped in to try to hold her under. The rub in this one was she could swim and he could not.
So, he
swam safely to land and recovered from hypothermia. He lost consciousness in the 2-degree water and was pulled out by police, transported, fell into a coma. Now, the police did charge him with attempted homicide for low motives, but he succumbed to death on Valentine's Day.
Wow. That's some bad luck right there.
That is some bad luck.
So, if you're listening, babe, don't get mad at me, get in a fight with me, and try to kill me. Yeah. Apparently that doesn't end up well.
She's going to pop right back like a quirk.
Yeah. Hell hath no fury like a scorned woman.
Or a woman in icy water.
It is a bit like trying to baptize a cat.
I just washed my hair. Really?
Darwin did disclose that they normally do not nominate people where someone else is harmed, but because she made a full and swift recovery, they decided to let this one slide.
Girl power.
Speaking of girl power, I've got a little list here, and this is going to help solve some of these arguments for men, because men don't understand women, and so I saw this, and I thought I'd share it with all the guys listening out there, and this is deadly terms used by women.
Oh,
this is going to translate it for you guys. Okay, the first one is fine, okay?
Which means it's not fine.
Nothing is okay.
That's a word that women use when they just want to end an argument, and you need to shut up.
Yes.
Fine, okay? Nothing. This means
everything.
Something definitely.
It means you should be worried. Okay?
You should stay away from icy water.
Yeah. And whatever.
Mm.
And that's a woman's way of saying that you're stupid. And
I'm
going
to get you raised while you're asleep.
Stupid and wrong.
Yeah. And that's okay. Now, that's okay means it's not okay. That means that she's thinking long and hard about how you're going to pay for what you've done. That's okay. That's fine.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That's a combo, right?
It's nothing.
It's fine. And it's okay.
Yeah.
And then I get it. It's nothing. Yeah.
And then go ahead.
Which means you better sit your back on the couch.
That's a dare. Yeah. That is not permission.
Yeah.
Don't do it.
A definite dare.
And then the bonus word was wow. And wow means this is not a compliment, okay? This means that she's amazed with how stupid that one person can be.
Wow kind of encompasses all of those.
She's talking to herself, like, how did I get into this?
Yeah, how did I get here?
Yeah. What possessed me to think this would be a good idea? Wow.
Now, so, guys, this is going to save your marriage.
Mm-hmm.
And your wife says, go ahead.
Oh, yeah.
I'll tell you the one that my husband is probably, if he were here, he would probably say that I do this. But I get to the point, I'm like, whatever you're about to say, you're right.
Oh, yeah.
You're right. I agree. You're right. Whatever you're about to say. We can stop talking about this now because you're right. I give. Yes.
Yeah. I made that up. It wouldn't. Yeah.
Yeah.
It wasn't true.
No. Yeah. I'm totally wrong. You're totally right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Surely not. Not at the deal right now.
That just means I don't want to hear your voice anymore.
Yes. Yeah. I'm not talking about this anymore. I'm shutting down.
Zip it.
This is me shutting down. I'm giving you the win. You know, although he doesn't appreciate that kind of win.
A win only in his mind.
Yeah, in his mind, he's like, no, that's not really a win. Like,
I just can't imagine you guys, so both of you are attorneys, so like I see your arguments and I haven't seen your arguments literally, but I'm just imagining that you like build a case against each other before you go into this.
It gets pretty intense. But you know, at some point I'm just like, it doesn't matter what I say. He's just gonna stick by wrong. You know?
Yeah.
And you can't. I mean,
so
you can't win with that.
So you have dementia.
So I just shut down.
Your memories failed you, and you're right.
I should shut it down. I'm not talking about it anymore. I cannot battle selective memory, okay?
You can't.
It's very hard to battle selective memory.
I think we all suffer from spouses that have that. This is going to turn
out
the worst court.
We know Bill and Hillary.
You'll have to call in and take it to Judge Jess, and we'll decide.
Yeah. Yep. I like it.
I heard somebody say Hillary, like, they always say in the news that President Trump, he lied, he lies, you know. Hillary struggles with the truth.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
I mean, she's like, how do you struggle with it? Are you fighting it? Like,
I don't want to lie. I want to tell the truth.
Not only does she struggle with the downward dog, but she also struggles with the truth.
She struggles with the truth. And that's why I noted this, saw that they did a survey, and 11% of the population in the United States believes that Hillary Clinton is honest and trustworthy. However, 14% believe in Bigfoot. So,
there you have it. You're right. Uh-huh.
Well, she does walk in
whatever
the woods.
Whatever you say.
That's true.
She does walk in the woods.
That's true. And she's been she's been elusive like Bigfoot lately. Where is she?
Don't question that. Just embrace it, Jessica.
No. You can't embrace it because, oh, Hillary, she's like kids when the house gets really quiet. When she's not saying much and she's out of the picture, she's like a kid that's up to no good, and you know, why is it so quiet? That means she's up to something bad.
She's trying to figure out who she's gonna murder next.
I guess
she's just laying low. She's filling the walls, closing in, maybe.
Yeah.
Oh, suicide.
She'll just take him out. Suicide. Two shots in the back of the head. Suicide.
That's the way it works.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying, all these people going up against Trump, like his lawyer and all these people, I'm like, they better be glad it's Trump. Because if it were Hillary, they wouldn't have an opportunity.
They would have one of those awards.
Yeah.
How do you shoot yourself in the back of the head?
Twice.
Yeah. That was the first one. Yeah, the first one didn't get me, but the second one did.
It was the Vince Foster that was supposed to have done that, right?
Yeah, in the park.
Yeah, in the park.
Walking in the park.
With no blood on the ground. No. They found him.
Well, you know, if you're going to do it, you do it twice, you do it clean, you do it in the back. Yeah. Okay.
And they found his thoughts.
He's a perfectionist. Quarters.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. She just borrowed them.
Doesn't know really how they got there.
Struggling with the truth.
Yes, the housekeeper.
I don't know. It's in one of the emails I sent.
I was like, yes.
Yeah, gosh.
I don't know.
Poor Hillary.
It's got to be hard to be the brat of so many jokes.
I guess so.
But maybe it was Yoga's fault she didn't get elected. I don't think they blame her.
I don't blame you. I would have blamed Yoga.
She blamed everything.
Somebody should write her and tell her you forgot.
She doesn't blame China either.
I'm sure it's coming. Now that that's out there, she should go back on The View. She's got two new things to blame.
There you go.
Well, you know, China's denying it, and let's see, who else? The FBI is denying it, of course.
Well, we all blame them.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And
they struggle with the truth.
China's denying it so far, but the, who is the, how do you say that? Who was supposed to have reported that?
I got nothing.
Oh, the Intelligence Community Inspector General.
How do you say that?
Intelligence Community Inspector General. IG.
That's different.
That's like a hard word to pronounce.
ICIG, right? Well, they are not releasing a statement.
Oh, speaking of initials, go ahead. Let's finish that. Okay.
Well, you're done. Right. So the FBI disputes it, China denies it, but the ICIG declined to comment. So what does that tell you?
Somebody's struggling with the truth.
They're struggling with the truth. They have selective memory.
But I also saw that they said all of our, like, we had spies in China that were killed during this time when her emails were supposed to be being hacked. And we had all these secret agents that, I guess they committed suicide. I don't know.
In the park. Just taking a walk in the park.
Yeah.
Thought I would die. Speaking of initials, you know how we've got the LGBTQAI, right?
I just got to Q, and that's
it. And we added one. Because we're identifying as a male.
We're identifying as a husband.
Yes.
A husband and father.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm, yeah. But anyway, I thought, you know, that's not very inclusive of the heterosexuals. So I think we should have shirts that say hashtag H. Since there's LGBTQAI, very exclusive of the H's.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, we're left out. Like, the inclusive group is leaving a big group out.
How about I'm an HC? Conservative.
Oh, ooh.
Oh, yeah.
We're not trying to die, Denise. I don't know her. I don't know what she's talking about.
I didn't wear that shirt you came to our school, right?
That's a racist shirt, that's a really offensive shirt you came up with.
I'm trying to be inclusive, okay? We're leaving out all the people we don't agree with. Did you ever get your MAGA hat?
No, I still haven't.
Oh.
Yeah. I need to, though. I'm going to. I promise I'm going to. I just haven't done it.
Yeah.
No, I'm not scared. I just haven't done any online shopping.
What's up with that?
You were really sick last year.
I know. I'm so sick. Did you lose your cat? Oh, my word.
Oh, my word.
Well, we better take a little song break.
Yeah, I'm going to. To dedicate this one to Michael Jackson. You know, his birthday was yesterday. How old would Michael Jackson be if he were alive?
Probably 60,
maybe.
He was 50 when he died, right?
I think so. I'm not real sure.
I think he was 50. I miss
the man, Michael. The myth, the legend.
I miss
the king of pop.
The king of pop. The king of pop. King of pop. What was Elvis? The king of
rock.
Rock and roll.
Yeah.
Yes. And we know who's the king of country. George Strait.
King of country.
King George.
Who's the king?
Garth Brooks.
King of rap.
No.
King of rap.
I don't even know any
rap.
I mean, Tupac.
I would say Tupac.
Mm-hmm. He didn't get thrown to an icy river, though.
No.
He got one of those gangster bullets.
What did he know on Hillary?
Yeah. He had some
knew about Hillary before. Knowing about Hillary was big.
He was cool before it was cool.
Oh, man.
I don't know if y'all remember this, but the Jackson 5. Do you remember the Jackson
5? I remember the Jackson 5.
I don't remember.
I'm gonna show you what it's all about. A cartoon on Saturday morning.
Oh, yeah, I watched the cartoon before. Yeah.
Yeah. That was when Michael Jackson looked sort of normal.
Yeah, that's when I really liked him. I mean, I liked him now, but he just seems more.
It's just like too many nose jobs.
I said something to Caleb, and we were just having a conversation, and I said something about Janet Jackson, and that was, Michael Jackson's sister, or whatever, and she was like, what? And I was like, yes, Janet Jackson is Michael Jackson's sister. And she goes, Michael Jackson was black? She legitimately did not know that.
There are before pictures.
Well, he had that disease, I know everybody questions it, but I read an article one time by his makeup artist.
I thought he had some burn scars or something like that.
No,
from the Pepsi commercial.
I remember when that happened.
You should get burned if you're doing a Pepsi commercial.
That's true. A lot of people have it.
I'm COVID.
Vitiligo.
Yes. And that's where you get the
patches.
Pigmentation in your skin goes, and it ultimately takes your whole color out of your skin, but it takes a long time. So people that suffer from that have a lot of image, sometimes if they're not strong in their self-esteem, have some image issues. And
just makes you wonder what kind of child
they had. When did it come down on him? Because you didn't see it before. When did it come down on him? In adulthood?
In adulthood.
It does. It happens in adulthood.
Yeah. I've read several articles on vitiligo. Interesting.
He's a big fan of Peter Pan.
There's a model now that has that. Have you seen it?
Yes, that's one I read one recently.
Yeah.
She's very pretty, and good for her. You know what I mean? But, I can see just being every normal day guy or girl trying to live with that. Especially Michael Jackson, who's on stage in front of thousands of people. And then you got everyone saying, he wants to be white. And
I think he did have body dysmorphia, though, because he kept just chopping his nose more and more.
Yeah. Pretty intense.
Yeah, I think he had an intense childhood, too.
For sure.
Very sad.
He didn't, I don't think he had a childhood.
Making that money
for his big daddy.
But he was talented. I mean, he was a talented artist. Yeah. He was a talented writer. And I think he had foresight. Like, he bought a bunch of the Beatles music.
Yeah.
Bought the rights to it.
Mm-hmm.
I think he could,
I'm sure he felt like he carried the 5.
Oh, well, yeah. He totally did.
Yeah.
Kind of like Donnie carried the Osmonds.
You only liked one of the Osmonds, Denise.
There's only one of the Osmonds.
There's more than one Osmond. I thought you were going to say Donnie carried the New Kids.
No, I'm not a New Kid. I'm not a New Kid on the block.
What?
No.
I don't know. Take me off your collar, Austin.
That was the 90s, remember?
Oh, yeah, I didn't participate
in the 90s. Yeah. I didn't participate in the 90s.
Mm-hmm. I love Mason New. In KOTB.
Mm-hmm.
Heather Blanket.
Oh, my sister was her, number one.
You were hanging tough, weren't you?
I was hanging tough. Oh.
I would have beat you up.
And there's something crazy, and you want to take a chance. I love it. Don't get me wrong, baby. November rain. Chill you to the core.
I did like New Kids. I did.
I just saw them last year. So, Boys to Men open and Paula Abdul.
anyone
wanting to hang with the cool kids, you just come see me after the show.
Yeah, all 5 of you.
Isn't it weird, though, how they traded places, the brothers? Like, it was Donnie was the big star. Mark was like, oh, he's Donnie's brother. And now Mark Wahlberg is, like, big. He's the... What was he? What did he used to become? Marky Mark.
Donnie loves it when you say
that.
It's not. Oh, and his other brother's like a hamburger cook.
So now
making the Wahlbergs feel good.
Hey, they make some really good burgers, though.
Well, I think Mark's little man syndrome kind of, you know, drove him to really.
You think so?
No, they do make some good burgers. Yeah. Don't get me wrong. Best burger in the big ATL right there.
Really? I've never had their burgers.
Oh, man. So if you go to a Braves game, you can go over to Wahlburgers.
Yeah.
I'm talking about a good burger. I'm talking about the burger, probably.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
All different kinds of burgers.
Oh, man.
I saw the Bistro's got a new burger. Saw it on Facebook.
Is it a Wahlberg burger, though?
Yeah.
I don't know. It's branded. It's got a brand on it.
Well, if it's not branded, I'm not eating it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
To be wasting like, my time.
You need your meat tattooed, right?
I don't know if you're tattooed or forget about it. Don't bring me something off the grill if there are no lines.
No.
Okay?
No. Gotta have the
lines. You just be
all
about
marked
that.
Up. All marked
all
up.
All marked up. I like it. I like it like a biker. Okay?
Yeah.
I like my meat like I like my bikers.
Branded. Tattoos.
Tattoos.
A little greasy.
A little well done, crispy.
Bad for you. It's so good.
Tastes a hint of gas.
Oh, my word. There's so many other things I could say, but I'm not going
to. So many other burger over here. Yeah.
Good thing we're on the air.
Oh, man. No help.
We always go back to food. We always end up like,
because we're all starving.
We're talking about food.
1,000% of the time.
Didn't the world revolve around food?
Is there something else to think about?
I'm sure there's recipes on Hillary's emails that we lost somewhere that
that's
we've
why,
lost.
That's why Bill's starving. Have you seen him? He's very emaciated.
How do you know we're not? She's not, like, killing him.
Oh, yeah.
There's no telling.
She probably is. I saw a picture of him, and I think it was, like, dude from Van Halen, or two people that are the same age, and Bill looked like he was about to die, and the other looked like he was living the good life, you know?
Bill's had to say, you're right.
Van Halen
times. He's giving up on life.
Yeah.
He's like, you're right.
Or Steven Tyler.
You're right. Whatever you say, you're right. Steven! Don't even get me
started.
Yeah,
Steven Tyler. I think that's your... Is that who you need to
say? No, I think it was... I can't remember who it was.
Eddie Van Halen?
Maybe. I can't remember, but... There was a marked difference in the vegan Clinton and the... Mm-hmm. You know, the one who doesn't kill people and steal and screw over the country. I think he sleeps better, probably, than Bill, maybe. I don't know.
I'm sure Bill sleeps with one eye open at all.
I would. If I was going to bed with him, I'm sure they're not going to bed together.
With bank lock security.
Yeah.
Lock door and security.
I'm going to go to bed now, wife.
He better be glad. Doesn't he get Secret Service protection for the rest of his life?
Yeah.
There's no reason he's still here.
There ain't anybody that needs it, Bill, then.
Yeah, well, I made you some coffee.
Yeah.
Yeah, you brought up Steven Tyler, though. I don't know if our audience has heard that he sent a cease and desist to the president because he doesn't want him to play his music at the rallies, which I thought he always played the Stones, but then I heard he played Dream On every once in a while.
Every now and then.
Yeah.
Why would he not want him to play it, though?
Well,
other than he's a liberal.
This is my whole thing. I think he didn't mind. And then this whole, like, the hashtag MeToo thing started. And he knows that anybody that's associated with the president or is even perceived to be supporting the president, that they're going to come after him. And he has a lot that people could go after. He had a 14-year-old girl that was a groupie. And he basically talked her parents into giving him guardianship so that she could live with him.
Paid them, didn't he?
He did. He paid the mother, and she signed over custody of the little girl to him. And he lived with the little girl for three years.
Mother of the year.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
At 16, he got this girl pregnant. And this is, like, his own admission. In two of his books, Walk This Way and Does the Noise in My Head Bother You? That's the other name of the book. But he admits it in both books. 16, he got her pregnant. She had an abortion, which he basically, I couldn't say he forced her, but he was her guardian, and he pushed her to do it. But she was, like, 5 months pregnant. It was, like, a late-term abortion, yes. Then he boots her out. Like, he's done with her by the time she's 17. He's done. He's moving on. And I'm thinking, you're going to take the moral high ground here and say, you know, you just can't support this president because he's so sexist.
Yeah, maybe we should cease and desist Steven Tyler.
I already have. I have. And that's sad for me because I did like his music, but I always...
I love Aerosmith.
I did, but after... I didn't know that. An interview on, I don't know if it was on Oprah or Barbara Walters or something, but I remembered hearing that before about the 14-year-old, and I always thought he was creepy after that.
Yeah, I was not aware of his tendencies towards pedophilia.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, like, what, I'm rich, so I can just buy it? I mean, I don't even understand.
He was, like, 28 then, and she was 14, so...
Right. Well, that makes it all right.
What is wrong with her mother?
Called greed.
Gross.
I don't know. He should have been arrested. And so I don't know why, like, the hashtag MeToo gals didn't go after him. Oh, I know why now, because he's against the president. So since he's against the president, he's just a champion for human rights.
So,
give me a break.
Speaking about pedophiles, what do you think about all this going on in the Catholic Church? And do you think the Pope is going to have to step down?
I doubt it.
Tell me about what is happening, Denise. Somehow I've missed that.
Well, you know, it's not news.
I knew that she
slept last week.
I thought something maybe new had happened. I knew that there was, like, you know, these pedophiles in the priesthood, but is something new came out?
Well, they just got really good notes now that it was, you know, covered up.
Yeah, that went all the way up the flagpole to the Vatican.
Yeah, he knew about it. And he actually knew about it and covered it up, so.
Have they confirmed that he knew? I knew that they confirmed that, like, they put the Vatican on notice. But I don't know if they confirmed that, like, that means it went all the way through to him or just
they're pretty much saying that he knew personally, I think.
Wow.
And helped cover it up. I mean, I know he's not the only one, but...
And that's this...
I don't understand why you cover that up. Like,
and he was
this is not rocket science.
No, and the archbishop that came on and was interviewed and said, you know, the Pope has more important things to do. He's got to talk about the environment and,
you know what I'm really confused about.
He's going to go down this rabbit hole and chase
this. Obviously, the archbishop doesn't have a PR person.
This Pope he's too busy with politics. You know, he said, Christians don't build walls, and that was a dig at our president. And there's, like, a 40-foot wall around the Vatican, so...
Just
don't want to offend any Catholics because, you know, I respect that, but this priest, I mean, this Pope, he's a little different.
If he knew, he needs to go. If you would think, one would think, and if they learned of something of that nature, they would nip it in the bud so fast. Get rid of those people. Turn those people in. No, do whatever you need to do.
Move them to another.
Yeah, I don't understand that. That makes no sense. There's probably plenty of people wanting to be priests who, you know, don't want to have sex with little boys.
True.
I don't know. You know, I'm like, what is going on? I mean, and I do believe that, you know, it's not just the Catholic Church.
There's stories and stories
of all these churches that, you know, all these things are happening. Men in a position of power have an opportunity to be alone with young boys or young girls. Okay, so all those disclaimers, but... You know, I was talking with someone who was saying the Catholic Church does sort of, because they have this whole position that, you know, you give your life to God, you don't get married, you don't have, you know, set, you're chaste, all those things, you know, it makes it, you know, you're kind of deprived in that area a little more than maybe the Baptist or the Methodist or, you know.
But I disagree because I don't think that that wouldn't make you attracted to children. You know what I'm saying? Like, maybe you might cheat and go get a prostitute or something, but it wouldn't make you attracted to children. And I think that they're pedophiles, and I think that's why they go into it. It's something that gives them access to kids, you know? It's
right. Just... Absolutely.
So that's a fun topic we've got on this one.
Good chat, girls. Good chat. How about those bears?
Well, I just seen it come across the television screen over there. It caught my eye, so...
The Pope thing?
The Pope.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Pope Francis. Is that what it is?
Yeah.
Pope Francis.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Gotta get
bye-bye. So, have we ever had a Pope resign before?
No, this would be like a first.
So how do they all manage to, like, slowly die in the little tower? Like, you never have a Pope have a heart attack and just... Pope died yesterday. You know, it's always like everybody's waiting. Mm. We're looking at the smoke. And then it changes color and we know he's passed.
They probably have really good medical care. Maybe that's why.
Pope doctors?
Like Pope doctors.
I would kind of like a Pope doctor.
Yeah.
I want to live into my old age. And then when it's about that time, I want everyone to gather outside. And
go up and smoke.
Yeah. Boom. That's right. There you have it.
There we go.
Now, this will be a first. I don't think they've ever impeached a pope or a pope has had to step down. So,
I don't know if he's going to impeach a pope.
Well, I'm just using the liberals' women. It's always impeach, impeach, impeach.
Isn't that crazy?
The need to impeach. Isn't that what the two richest men in the United States, that's their go-to, that's their cause, the need to impeach? Soros.
Oh, yeah.
Who's the other one? Is it hard to say?
Yeah, it's hard to say.
How do you say that?
Like, I was trying to use the right term here, okay? You didn't know. I said, how do you say that? You could have sprung out with it. Busted out with some. I see now. I still have to look on my notes. What is it, Jesse? You know right offhand.
That's just where fun comes in.
Just that off the top of your head,
Jessica. Hey, whatever you say is right. Yeah. Okay.
The intelligence community inspector general. Now Denise is all off
the
track.
ISIG. I know. Now I don't even know what I'm talking about.
Sorry.
The ISIG.
Not like I knew before. The ISIG. Ooh, is that like a new vape cigarette or something?
I don't know. I got an e-cig.
I-cig and e-cig.
What was that thing?
I can remember it now.
Oh, I seen something when we were in Nashville this weekend. The little dragon breath things. Have y'all seen those?
No, what is this?
They're like little...
Is that something we desire?
Balls of... No, they say it's really bad, but they're like selling them in the mall. Little balls of... Maybe nicotine or something.
Oh, that sounds like it's for me.
Like candy almost, and you put it in your mouth and blow out smoke.
Oh, gosh.
Dragon breath.
I'm going to be like Game of Thrones when I get that. I'm going to be coming through just blowing out smoke.
Yeah.
But they say it's dangerous?
Yeah, so I don't see how they're selling it in the mall. Looks like candy.
Can you buy it if you're underage?
Probably not.
You should have tried, Denise, because you look young.
I know. I didn't have my driver's license with me. I knew they were going to card me.
Just forget it.
Forget it.
You're right.
I don't know. Whatever you say next is right. Okay. However you pronounce it, Jessica, is fine.
I know it's fine. Wow. I know it's fine.
I've got a question for you. You know, the guys are talking about a morning job. A skill set that you learned on one of your first jobs that you will never use again.
Well, my first and probably next 12 jobs were waiting tables. And I'm pretty sure I still do that at home.
So you're still using that.
All those skills. I'm carrying multiple plates to the table. I'm carrying cups. I'm getting salt, pepper.
And you were a bartender, and I know you're still using those skills.
But that wasn't my first job. My actual first job, when I think about it, was I worked in a chicken house as a kid. Before that, I worked on a peach orchard, picking peaches, I wouldn't count that as like a job. My real first job was in a chicken house, picking up eggs. Yeah.
Does it stink?
Oh, yes.
Are you kidding?
I couldn't.
You ever smelled the chicken house?
I couldn't eat eggs or chicken for years and years. But you know what was really fascinating about that job? When they get new chickens and all the old chickens have to go. And they bring in these guys, these chicken chasers, right? And they catch the chickens. And it's honestly, it was like fascinating to watch these guys chase down the chickens. And like they catch the chickens and they have like 5 chickens in each hand. They grab them like underneath by their legs. And they hold them by their feet, like upside down, and they're just throwing them in, and they can clear out, like, I know it sounds...
Wow, well, I don't need a resume, chicken chaser.
You know what, and they make a lot of money. They make like $30,000 a year, these chicken chasers.
They should work in a daycare.
Yeah, so, I mean, it's not a great amount of money, but I'm thinking some teachers start out about that much, right? I mean...
Why go to college when you chase chickens?
Just chase chickens.
Goodness.
Ooh, other than being clawed to death.
And all that. But, you know, you see those trucks that, like, are transporting chickens or whatever?
Mm.
And you see them and they have, like, all those chickens on there. But, so, I know someone in the business. And, you know, he told me, you know, you see them on the interstate. You know how many chickens die on those trips?
Oh, it's all of them?
Guess. Just take a guess.
All of them?
5.
Really?
Really?
5 is the average.
I would think a lot of them might have head injuries.
What is your source? What is your source?
Yeah.
Well, thanks, God. G-U-I.
Can't reveal it. It's pertinent information.
Yeah. Well, I'm just saying. You know,
I thought
there would be a lot more dead chickens.
I didn't know you knew a chicken guy. That's news to me.
I know, yeah. I know 2 chicken guys, actually. They're brothers. Wow. Brothers and chicken.
Is one of them Colonel Sanders?
You win. Are you talking about Reba McEntire?
He married Mrs. Winner.
I know Colonel Sanders and Mrs. Winner very well. We have dinner at least once a month.
I don't know Mrs. Winners at all.
That's good. Yeah. Dippers.
What about Mr. Bojangles? Dance.
Told you we'd go right back to food.
We'd
circle back every time.
Back around.
Oh, Bojangles was a dancer, not a chicken man.
I'm leaving here. I'm getting a hamburger and some fried chicken. Soon as I leave.
Speaking of being on the run, did you hear Cleveland's excitement this week?
No, dude.
The thief. Running out of coals. There was a high-speed chase.
No, I've got it up.
Shots were fired.
My 7-year-old informed me of this.
Yeah. I mean, what do you steal from Kohl's? Kohl's bucks?
I don't know. I think they're pretty hard up. Stealing Kohl's.
Maybe that's why they thought they could get away with it. They're like, nobody thinks anybody's going to steal this crap.
I mean, they give you the Kohl's cash, Kohl's bucks.
You might have to steal it in there, because sometimes I think they're overpriced.
They're proud of their crap.
Yeah, you've got to have some Kohl's bucks.
I mean, what you want to go down is, I knocked over the Kohl's.
In Cleveland, Ohio, Tennessee.
Got some hard time.
Yeah. Well, it was like her and her man, right? And then it got even crazier. They got on this chase. Somehow he jumped out.
The state got involved.
Chasing him down the interstate. Then she gets out of the car, and she's surrounded by police officers. She manages to shoot twice or something.
But they didn't rob the place. It wasn't like an armed robbery. This was like they stole some...
Sweaters.
Yeah.
Socks. Underwear.
I mean, they stole like some Ralph Lauren chaps. Like, they don't have the polo. They got chaps. Yeah. If I'm going to jail, I'm going for like the polo, Ralph. Yeah. Not chaps.
No, not going for chaps. Wouldn't be prudent. Not going to net.
Going down. Not going to be for the chaps.
No.
But she shot them. They shot her, but she lived. You know what I mean? Like,
that should be a Darwin. Yeah, that should be a Darwin.
She was award. I think she was white, so.
Ooh.
She was resilient.
Resilient.
That was racist.
Things you gotta do.
That was racist. Like H. Okay?
Things you gotta do to get some new chaps, I guess.
Yeah.
I'm just saying.
Yeah.
So, knock over the Kohl's.
Did she not know that Target was right next door?
I was
going
to say,
Vera Wang for Kohl's or something.
Yeah, they do.
Yeah, I'm not going for that. If I'm going...
Maybe she wanted like a... Maybe it was off. Maybe it wasn't about the clothes. Maybe it was about the food processor. The coffee, the Keurig. You know, those things are kind of pricey.
I'm just saying.
No, everybody loves a good Keurig.
If I'm going to get shot at, it's going to be because I'm running out of there with a Louis Vuitton double bag somewhere.
I'm not I'm coming out of Cartier.
Yeah.
No, not cold.
Not a Chaps Polo.
Wouldn't be prudent.
It's just hard for me to believe.
They really wanted that stuff. They put up a fight to keep that stuff, didn't they?
I know.
They were not playing.
They were not
Kohl's let it be known. You do not steal from us.
That's true. Okay?
So, if you think anybody's gone into Kohl's and tried to lift anything after that,
no.
You'll get shot.
There's going to be a high-speed interstate chase. Yeah, you're going to get shot. You're going to go to jail.
They now posted that on their doors. We take shoplifting seriously.
I mean, we had it in the dressing room, but she was going for the Keurig. So, now it's on the front door.
Yeah, there it is.
Not playing around.
Not
a shoplifting audience. Just saying. Kohl's is not the way to go.
No, they're serious.
Hey, just because we don't appreciate Chaps doesn't mean Kohl's doesn't. Okay?
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, my word.
I don't know how, but an hour has passed.
That's right.
So, this is hashtag H. Hashtag HC.
Who do you want to be today?
How do you pronounce that?
The I-C-I-G.
She's a hashtag I-C-I-G.
I'm never forgetting that again. What does it stand for,
Jason? How do you pronounce it?
Oh, it's right on top of everything. I was trying to think. I didn't want to say the whole thing.
You're just looking for the acronym.
Yeah.
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 Anyway. LGBTQIA.
Yeah, it's so confusing. It's confusing. It's like algebra now with all these letters.
I want some initials.
I know. That's what I'm saying. They're not being very inclusive of the H-ers.
That's right.
And I think it's wrong.
Or the C-ers.
You know, the nonconformists are now the conformists.
That's true.
And we are the nonconformists. So.
That's true.
Again, I say if you want to hang with the cool kids.
That's right. And if you're going to lie for a friend.
And you're going to steal a heart.
Going to cheat death.
And you're going to drink with the morning mimosas. And now, men jumping on trampolines.
This is for all the 5 fans of New Kids on the Block.
Woo-hoo! There's got to be 10 of us.
a big kid now. Went from baby bottles to drinking from sippy cups. Went from wearing diapers to rocking these fat bullocks. We're 50 million strong, so put on your pull-ups and help us sing this song.
Time was a blast. Third time. cabin door while I dream of Mississippi and you. And my memories are bringing happy days of yore I have spent in Mississippi with you. Sure. Yes, I miss the Mississippi and you. The Mississippi and you. We'll be right back.